In Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet, Juliet famously proclaims, "My bounty is boundless as the sea, my love as deep. The more I give to thee, the more I have, because both are infinite." Juliet does an interesting thing here. She aligns her love for Romeo with the ocean, with the sea. But then she goes on to say that it's boundless and it's infinite. Well, the problem is that we know that the ocean, while incredibly deep, is not boundless and it's not infinite. And this uncovers an interesting truth about the concept of this thing we call love. Love is the theme of this second week of Advent. Now, when we look through human history, it's interesting that there's no shortage of people writing and thinking and singing about love. All the way from Shakespeare to Beyoncé, everyone in between and many beyond have talked about and written about love. But when they do, they're most often talking about and writing about and singing about not so much the nature of love qualitatively, but more about love quantitatively, why we need more love, why love is the most important thing, why we love, whom we love, what we love. These are all quantitative questions. Very rarely do we take a step back and think about the actual nature and quality of what love is. Well, thankfully, about 1,500 years before Shakespeare wrote Romeo and Juliet, another great thinker and writer who happened to be a follower of Jesus, his name was Paul, he wrote qualitatively about love. And he wrote that love was many things, amongst others, patient and kind and not envious and various other things that are great and they resonate so easily with the human heart. But then he took it to another level and he set what can only be described as an impossible standard for the purest form of love. He said, love always protects. Love is not self-seeking. And love never fails. I don't know about you, but that is the kind of love that I am simply not capable of in my own strength. But that is the kind of love that Paul was pointing to all those years ago when he was pointing to the love that came down that very first Christmas when Jesus came, when God came into the world in love. He did it exuding and demonstrating love in its purest form. Sacrificial love, selfless love, love that looks to protect. He came down for our sake, not for his sake. That's the love that you and I have access to this Advent season and this Christmas season in and through the person of Jesus Christ. And my hope for you this season is that you will find that love. Thanks again for joining me, and I'll see you next week.